Hello all, welcome to this second session of day one under the IQSE PGDAV College webinar series BASIC. I am Shikha Menani, Assistant Professor PGDAV College, and today we would be talking about Edmodo, another content management system or learning management system. The advantage of using Edmodo is that when the students log in Edmodo, then they need to provide their parents' email ID and contact number. We also have an autonomous poll and wellness check in Edmodo. We can award badges to the meritorious students in Edmodo, and we have a library in Edmodo itself where we can save all our work, and then we can slowly disseminate it to our students. So these are certain advantages of Edmodo over and above the Google Classroom. So let's get started. Make sure you have your mobile phones and your laptops to practice along with me. To start with Edmodo, type in your browser Edmodo and you will get the link for Edmodo, which is edmodo.com. When you are using it for the first time, then you need to sign up and make sure that you sign up as a teacher or educator. And when your students are signing up for Edmodo, then they would also require to give their parents' contact number or email ID. So that is an advanced feature of Edmodo, which was not there in the Google Classroom. Now this is the home page of Edmodo that would appear when you sign up for the Edmodo and you log in to your account. The first thing that we need to do in any of the CMS is you need to change your profile. So here you can see that this is my picture over here with my name Shikha Menani, and you can also view the profile. If you need to edit it, how we can edit it? Go to this right side and click here. You can see here we have this tab which says profile. You just click on profile and you can upload your photo here. You can make various changes in your profile. And you can also share the profile link with other fellow teachers. So that we'll do later on. First, let us understand these various tabs and let us see how we can add different classes and give them the different material and quiz like we did in the Google Classroom. So this home tab is nothing but it is also like the stream which was there in the Google Classroom. But on this right side, you can see whatever is freely available throughout the Edmodo. So if you want to search for any technical class, you just type here, and if there is any free Edmodo class for technical issues, you can get the details out here and you can connect with them. So this is how you can find the Edmodo support. Now, the first thing that you need to do in any CMS is to create a class. There are two ways in which you can create a class. The first is on this home page, on the left hand side, you can see that there is this My Classes, and along with that, we have these three dots. So when we click on this, we can see whether we need to create a class, or the student needs to join a class, or we want to see the archived classes. So we will just click on this create a class. We can give it a name and we will just give this a name, and we can select a grade, the subject, and we can also choose the color. And this is the first way of creating a particular class. The other way to create a class is, for that you go to this classes tab and click on class management. Now when you click on class management, these are few of my classes that I created. So click on this plus sign and go to create class, just like we did in the Google Classroom. I can name it webinar series. You can describe your class. You have to select a grade. Now there are some limited options in the grade and the subjects. So you have to choose the closely available subject, click on create, and your new class would be created soon. When you create the new class, this box would appear which asks you to add students and to explore the class. So let us click on this add students, and when you click on this, you get this page which asks you to write the name of the students and their email ID. But this is a lengthy process. So what we can do is go back to the class, and this is the class that we have just created, the webinar series. Here you can see the class code. Click on this and this box would appear. You can simply copy the code from here and you can send it to your students. And when you think that enough students have joined your class, you can lock this code so that the classroom would be locked and no more students would be able to join. Similarly, by clicking these three dots, we can reset the code. So the features are same as were there in the Google Classroom. So now let us see what else we can do here. On the left hand side, for any class, we have certain posts. So this is like, if I want to write anything, say welcome. So you can add any picture from your device. You can also add from library. Now this is very important feature, and it differentiates your Edmodo from the Google Classroom, which we would be doing later on. Now, and you can also create a poll. Like if you want to ask, shall we start? So you can create a poll, click on this and type yes or no. So it will create an anonymous poll and your students can simply tell you whether they are understanding the topic or what do they want to be done in the next class and so on. If I want to ask them something else, let me type hello and let us ask them whether they are fine or not in this pandemic time. So I can click on this wellness check, and here you can see that I already have this wellness check. I can simply post it and the students would respond to me. So this is how it gives us this poll and this wellness check in advance. Now, so this is the class that we have created, and if we want to change the image for this particular class, what we have to do is we need to click on this add class image, again click on add class image and just browse for the image that is there on your device. I will take this image and I will save it and change my class image. So it is uploading and I will click on save button. So you can see that the image for this particular class, the main image would just change, and this is how my class would appear. So for every class you can have a separate image so that students are actually they feel good that this is their particular class. Now what else can be done? You have three dots out here. When we click on these three dots, you can see that we have this join URL. So this URL can be given to the students and they can join this particular class using this URL. Now let us see what else can be done for our class, how we can create the assignments and the quizzes. For that, click on this create button, go to assignment, go to new. In new, what we can do is we can give them the assignment. So we can just ask them developments in the banking sector. So we can give them the instruction, write at least 5 notable changes or development. So they will mention this, and we can attach the files from our device or we can also add the link. Let us see how we will add the link. Click on this add link, go to your browser, and we can see any, we can type anything that we want. So let us see banking development, and this is the link that I want my students to read. So what I'll do is I'll just copy this link from here and I will post it here and click on this attach button. and I can assign the assignment to the students. Now, as soon as you will click on assign, it will ask me to which class do you want to assign it to? To the current class, which is the demo class, or do you want to add it to the other classes that are here? Similarly, we can also select a due date by which the students have to submit their assignment. Suppose I choose 20th of July 2020, the time is automatically midnight, and we can lock it after the due date so that no student is able to submit this assignment after the due date. If we don't want to post it right now, we can also schedule it for later. So we can schedule it. If you want to do that, that can be done. But right now I'm just crossing this and I am assigning it to the students. So the item has been sent and the students would be able to view this in their Edmodo classes. You can see this is my class, the teacher's class. And here you can see in the stream that there is developments in the banking sector. And this is the link that I have attached with it. Similarly, let us see what else can be created. Let us go to create and let us go to quiz. In the quiz, we can either make a new quiz or we can load an existing quiz that has been made on this Edmodo platform by myself. So right now I'll click on new. And here we can see that there are two things. There are the quiz details and there are the quiz questions. So both these things have to be filled up for sure. So in the quiz details, we need to give the quiz a title. So you can give it any title. I'm giving it quiz 1. And we are writing 10 minutes time limit. And then we go to quiz questions. Now in the quiz questions, we have various options. We can write true, false, multiple choice, short answer, fill in the blanks, matching and multiple answer. Let us see them one by one. So when we go to true, false, I will write Ada is the regulator of banking sector, true or false, and I will mention that what is the correct answer. You can give the points. If you want to give it 2 points, you can do that. And next is, if I want to add a question, I will add new question from here. Yes, this would be a multiple answer, and here you can see that there are the check boxes, the question. So let us move to the next question. Let me have multiple choice. What is the example of life insurance? So I can write term, fire, or health. You can add more response if you want, and out of them I have to select the correct one, which is the term insurance. I can give it again 2 marks or whatever you want. I can also duplicate this question or delete this question. Let me add a new question and let me have it as a fill in the blanks. So in the fill in the blanks, how do we fill in the blanks? You can see that use underscore to specify where you would like a blank to appear in the text below. So let me write 1, then I will put a comma and underscore, again a comma 3, then underscore, again a comma 5, and so on. So you can see that as many underscores are put here, those many responses have come up, right? So what is the right answer? If I put one more underscore, then you can see that one more answer has come. So it depends upon you how many fill in the blanks you want to have. Now let us fill the correct answers. Let us write, obviously we know 2, 4 and 6. So these are the correct answers and I want to give 1 mark for each. So I have changed the grading to 3. So this is how we can add the fill in the blanks. Let us add a new question. And these changes are automatically saved as soon as you enter a new question. Let us go to matching. So in the matching is, identify the regulators, right? So I will write banking, then secondary market, then I'll write insurance. And here I'll write the answers. Banking is RBI, secondary market is SEBI, and insurance is Insurance Regulatory Development Authority of India. You can even add more responses and you can give it 3 points per correct answer. Right. So now let us preview this quiz, how it will appear. You can also drag this question. If you want to bring it down, you can use these dots to change the position of the question. If you want to bring it up, you can use this. So this can be done. So let us preview how the quiz would appear to before issuing it to the students. This is the first question. Let me write true. I have intentionally filled in the wrong answer. Let us go to next. Example of life insurance term. Next, fill in the blanks 2, 4 and 6. Let us go to next. And here what you have to do is the students have to drag it over here. So RBI, the correct answer has to be dragged here, then SEBI will come here, and then ADA would come here, and 4 of 4 answer, and there is automatic time limit that is coming. If you want to exit the preview, just click on this exit preview button and we will come back to our quiz. And now this quiz can be assigned to the students. So again, it will ask us to whom do we need to assign it. We can select the due date by which the students have to submit it, and lock after due date. Time limit you can change. As I mentioned in the instruction, it is 10 minutes. So the time limit of the quiz has been changed to 10 minutes. And do you want to randomize the questions so that for every student, the questions are not in this particular order? So I'll do that. I'll click on randomize the questions and I will click on assign. So as soon as I click on assign, we can see that this is the status of our quiz, and we'll click on got it. And you can see in this stream that quiz 1 has been posted for the student, but there are 0 submissions here. So as soon as a student would submit here, it would, if you click here, you will find out as to who has submitted, and from there you can just check the answers. Okay, so let me go back to the class. This is the class, and let us go to very interesting thing, which is this jumpstart activity which they have recently put in here. So it is like an activity but in the animated mode. You can have various games out here. So this you can try on your own, just see, because it takes some time to load. So it is also the same question but in a Kahoot style, that we play quiz on the Kahoot system. Similarly, we can create a new question here. So the same questions which we use for the quiz, we can make use of this jumpstart activity. So let us finish this and move to the members. The members are who all are the students enrolled in my class and who are the teachers enrolled in my this particular class. So when the students make use of the code, the student's name would appear here. I'll show you my group. Let us go back to the classes and I'll show you one class. And here you can see in under the members, you can see that there are 3 students in this particular class. These are the students. So 3 students, and there is one teacher, which is, it is my class, and no parents have been added yet. But if you want to add parent, then in front of the student, it is mentioned connect parent. So as soon as I click on connect parent, they would ask me whether I want to enter their email or mobile number. I can put that here, and so what will happen is any information related to the student about their progress would be automatically sent to the parent of this particular student using their email ID or the contact number. So this is one very important feature. Now let us see about the small group, what it is. If you want to click a small group that 10 of your students should be in one group and then next 10 in the other group, click on this plus, give it a name. Group 1, click on create. So this is a subgroup that has been created, you can see here. Okay, and here what you can do is go to the members. So when you want to add, click on add members to small group. Now these were the students who were there in my class. So out of them I can select that these 2 students would be in this small group, I will check them, I will tick them, and they would automatically come to my this small group. I just need to reload it and they would be added to the group number 1. So you can see here that in under group 1, these are the students now. Okay, so you can create small groups. If you want to delete any group, do these 3 dots and click on delete or archive. It's your choice. So delete this small group and now you only have 1 group. Let us see, once we have created the assignment and the quiz for the students, how can we assess them or how we can grade them. For that, what we have to do is we have to use this classes tab, and here you can see we have this class management, we have this what's due, that is there any assignment or quiz that is due for the students, and we have the progress also. This progress is used to see the whole class progress as to how much the class is understanding, as well as to see the progress of any individual student. First, let us see what is this what's due. When we click on this what's due, you would be moved to a page which will tell you that these are the certain assignment or quizzes which you have mentioned, and you can see that a class is also written. So this particular assignment was given for the class which I named as Shikha's class, and the color is blue. So it's always better that we change the color of every class to a different color so that it can be easily identified. So I know that these 2 belong to Shikha's class, then these 3 belong to this particular FMI class, then again this is Shikha's class and these are the FMI class. So these are the assignments. How many have been reviewed would be here, and how many are scheduled, that too would come here. Now how do I see the progress of the students? For that, what we need to do is we need to first look at the assignment of the students. How we can do that? So I will go back to the class management, and here I will click on this. On this right hand side, you can see that these are certain classes, and this is the date which is coming for the coming week, that is 12th of July to 18th of July. Pre-assigned, not viewed, and submitted. When I click, you can click on any one of them, and when you will click, you will find out here 0 turned in, 0 not turned in, that is 0 have submitted, 0 not submitted, and 3 have been graded, because there are 3 students in the class and all have been graded, so nothing has been left. So I can either send a reminder if I see that many have not turned in, many have not submitted their assignment. What I can do is I can click on this send a reminder, so that a reminder would be sent for this particular assignment to the students. Or what I can do is I can click on this graded, and you can see that these are the students who have submitted their assignment. I can just click any one of them and I can see their assignments. You can see here their marks are also written because I have graded them. I can also edit them using this pencil icon. Now let me show you the compiled statement of all the marks of this particular class. For that, go to classes and go to progress. Now when I go to progress, you can see that this progress is of the demo class where there is no student. So I can use this arrow and I can select the class for which I need to find out the progress or the marks. So I will click on FMI where I had these 3 students, and these are the quizzes or the assignments, and few of them have been marked while few are not marked yet. So how you can mark them? Either you can mark them from the assignment which I have already shown you, or you can also click here. So if you think that this student has got 10 on 10, so you can simply write it here. So you can use this also. Now one very important and interesting feature in Edmodo is to give the badges. So you can see here there are the badges. So if you want to give the badges to the students, how you will add that? These are the badges that I have given to the students. Okay. If you want to add a badge, just click on this add badge on this right side. And these are the badges which Edmodo provides you. You can also create your own badge if you want to do that, or you can select any of these badges. Just click on this, click on add badge to this group, and this is the badge. and you think that Soumya deserves this particular badge, so just click ahead of his name, and you can also select multiple students. So they would be awarded this badge, and this badge would be visible to all the students. So everybody would know as to which student has got which badge. And here you can see, if you will reload it, then you will see how many badges the student has got. Right, so here we can just see at the badges. You can see here that the student has got 2 on 4. It has also got 2 out of 5, 4, and this has got 3 out of 4. So this is how you can add the badges for your students. Now let us go back to the grades and let us see how we can export this particular file. If I want to export this particular file, click on export, and all these marks would be downloaded in an Excel file, which we did in the Google Classroom also. So you can save it for the future reference. In the next video, I will show you how the student can join this Edmodo class. Thank you so much. Now let us see what all we can do using our profile. If somebody asks me for my Edmodo profile, then how do we give them our Edmodo profile? For this, just click on my picture which is there on the top and go to settings. Now when you will go to settings, this is all that would be visible to the viewers when they visit the URL of your profile. Here you can give it a name. Right now it is given here. You can see this. This is the name, and you can just save profile URL. The URL is taken, so I need to take some other, and I will click on save profile, and this URL has been saved. We can simply click on this. You can see here, just copy this, and let us see how it would appear if we give it to anybody else and how they would view our profile. So I have pasted it on the other tab of the browser, and you can see that this is what has opened. This is my profile for Edmodo. All right. Now another thing that we can do with Edmodo is we can also view any particular student's progress. So let us go to the classes and go to any particular class where we have certain students. Here I'll go to members, because that is where I'll find the students and the teachers. And if I click on any student, you can see on this left hand side, it is about that particular student, where you find all the tags, that all the badges that have been given to this student. You can find the activity, that is there any post or replies by this particular student. You can also monitor the progress. So this is the progress of the student, and you can see the teacher schedule out here. So this is one thing that can be done using Edmodo, where we can view the detailed profile of all the students. Now let us go to the most important thing, which is library. So when we click on this library, what happens is, it is like the whole stock where you can just put in everything related to your subject so that you don't forget it later on. And from here you can slowly take out the material and it can be posted for the students. So how do we go about it? For adding any new material to the library, click on new, and what do you want to do? Do you want to upload a Word document, Excel worksheet, PowerPoint, file upload? What do you want to do? So I'll just click on file upload, and I will click on choose files, and I can select any of the files that I have, and it would be uploaded in my library. You can see that it has come and the date is also here. Now if I go to home and here I type something, let me write read this. So visible to, you can make it visible to any teacher on Edmodo, any teacher at Delhi University or your connections. So you can select any of these and you can post it. Or if you want to post it to any particular class, then you need to go to that particular class. So I'll go to my FMI class again, and I will put it here. So if you'll put it on the main tab, it will be visible to the Edmodo. And here what I can do is, this was the add attach files and images that we talked about in the first video. This is add from library. Click here and you can select any of these things which are there in the library. Just click on this and attach to post. So it has come here from the library and you can simply post it. Earlier it was not visible to the students because it was in the library, but now it would be visible to the students of my FMI class. So this is how you can just keep a record of all the things that you want to share for your subject. You can schedule everything and later on it can be posted. Let us go to this Edmodo Planner. So when I click on this Edmodo Planner, it is just like the Google Calendar where anything and everything that you have given to your students would be visible. You can see here that the quiz one for demo class is due. Similarly, an assignment for the demo class is due, which we created in today's webinar series. So this also helps us, and the students can view this as to what are the things that are approaching soon in their class. Let us go back, and now I would like to show you how the students would enter into the Edmodo and how they will submit their assignments. Now let us start with our last video, where we'll see how the students would join their Edmodo class and how they'll submit their assignments. But before that, I would like to tell you, if you want to go to any particular class, there are two ways of doing that. Either you can click here and all your classes to which you are the teacher would be visible, or you can go to classes and class management. So you can use either of these, and whichever way you are comfortable, you can decide. So now how to go to the students Edmodo? For that, I'll open the incognito window and I'll type Edmodo. So when I'll type Edmodo, now I need to sign up because this is for the student. So I'll click on the student account and sign up with Google. So this is the process that the students too would have to do. I'll put in my daughter's email ID. So the authentication with Google has been successful and the student is ready to sign up to their Edmodo account. So this is the Edmodo account of the student. Now what they have to do is, again, they'll go to these three dots and they will have to click on this join a class. Now you can see that to the students, you must tell that they have to sign up as a student so that they don't have the option of create a class out here. Okay. Now how the student would join? For that, they need to have the class code. So I'll copy it from here and I'll go back. And here I'll type join a class in the student's account. I'll paste the code and click on join. Right. So the student has joined my class. If I go back to the teacher's account, I can show you that now one student has been added here. Let me refresh it. And here you can see in the members, you can see that the student has been added here. Let us go to the student's account again. Here, everything has been posted, right? So the student can simply open it. And here, what the student has to do is, the student can either click a picture from their phone or they can write it in a Word document, a PPT, Google Slides, anything. And they can either create this Word document, PowerPoint presentation, or they can attach the files. And this is the way how the students would be submitting their assignments to the teacher. The last thing that we need to do in any of the content management system is, how do we delete a particular class if it is no more required at the end of the session? So what we can do is, we can click on these three dots and we can go to this advanced settings. Now, when I go to advanced settings, you can change the title of the class. If you think that the same students are there with you in the next semester also, you can simply change the name of the class, or you can archive the class or delete this particular class. So as soon as I delete this particular class, then it won't be available to me anymore. So this is the last thing that a teacher needs to be aware about, as to how you can archive or delete any particular class. I hope the session was interesting and you would be actually making use of it in the coming session. Thank you so much.